one of the first things I did was to go to this group about 10 blocks from here called Tiger 21.
Tiger 21.
Tiger 21.
Tiger 21.
Tiger 21.
Tell us what Tiger 21 is, the investment group for enhanced results in the 21st century. It's the premier network of peer-to-peer learning for high net worth investors.
Tiger 21 is a group of 200 of some of the world's best and wealthiest investors. Combined, they've got assets of over $18 billion.
One elite group that's taken notice is Tiger 21.
One of the world's most exclusive investment clubs.
Michael Sonnenfeld is founder of this unique group.
Michael Sonnenfeld made his fortune in real estate. He founded Tiger 21 in 1999.
Tiger 21 is a learning organization for high net worth investors.
We have more American members, but a growing Canadian promise. The members who grew these businesses at some point sell their businesses, and for the first time, they're managing money rather than people, assets, and businesses.
Or they could have been the head of a New York Stock Exchange company and retired, and now for the first time, they're investors. Their economic life is based on the returns they're going to earn in investments, and they join a confidential group.
Members like Les Quick, formerly of investment firm Quick and Riley, who says he's learned some valuable lessons from his peers.
When we sold our company, I had a big single stock position, and my group has beat on me to get out, cut your exposure. Stock's down 25%. I lightened up, so thank you, group.
This is serious business. This is about learning about asset allocation, what's working, how do you take charge as the CEO of your investment company to manage effectively in a very difficult world.
How much did you save?
Probably on the order of $5 million.
How do you guys go about selecting individual managers from the private equity space and the hedge fund space?
Sure. So that's what collective intelligence is all about. Part of our curriculum is every month you come and the members select with our curriculum department some of the best of breed managers who come in and talk to them. We're not an investment advisor. We create the infrastructure to tap into the collective intelligence of our members. And by now, we've had some of the best and top speakers all over the country because of the nature of our group.
So obviously, we've had a number of great speakers here. Yes. Kyle Bass, Glenn Hutchins, Barry Sternlicht, Sam Zell, just to name a few.
I want to get back to the Tiger 21 conference where Gary Kaminsky is with Hayman Capital's managing partner, Kyle Bass. Of course, famously known around the world for predicting the subprime crisis 6 years ago.
Wall Street's heavy hitters meeting in Palm Beach at the annual Tiger 21 conference.
Yesterday, Sam Zell presented to this group, and Sam Zell said the following: I can only promise you three things, death, taxes, and if you buy bonds today, you will lose money a year from today.
Bruce Berkowitz is one of the most influential money managers in America.
He spoke exclusively with Bloomberg at a conference held by the investor club Tiger 21.
How much worse do you think it's likely to get?
We think it's very probable that we're in a recession already. Now the question is, how bad will it be? And we think there's a significant probability it'll be the worst recession since the 1930s, since the Great Depression.
As people who are in the market every day, we're used to listening to a lot of noise. And by noise, we mean inconsistencies, aberrations, things that tend to go away. The noise became louder, and the inconsistencies went from being sequential to simultaneous. And at that point, a group of us said, wait a minute, this is not noise. These are signals. Something's going to burst. And when it bursts, it's going to be messy.
There'll be a Warren Buffett over the next 30 years. There may be a few Warren Buffetts. But the problem is, I don't know who those people are going to be, and I doubt if anybody else does. It's like looking for a needle in a haystack.
Private equity seems to be going up, which is so counterintuitive for some, given how difficult private equity was in the 2008, 9, and 10 period. But people are going back to basics, and they're putting money in companies that very often are in the same industries where they created their own wealth.
There is a movement back towards equity, but as I say, it's not a stampede. It's measured because there's still a lot of concerns about some dangerous issues out there.
Sure. So private equity is a better opportunity than stocks.
Well, private equity for people who have made their lives running small companies is something they're more familiar with, but we also have had an increase in public equity.
And the bonds made within Tiger 21 go beyond what Sonnenfeld ever imagined.
People traveled together. A couple of the people bought second homes together where they were neighbors out west where they were skiing. The amount of interaction between our members is really quite extraordinary.
A place of refuge for millionaires in these uncertain times.
When you have members who have all built world-class businesses, these are people who are at the top of their profession. And so to make this a valuable experience for them, something from which they can learn, is a real challenge. And that's what we've been honing our craft for the last decade.